There's no way to know when the bomb was dropped on Gaza, only that this was the day it went off, killing and wounding those around it. The blast struck in Beit Lahia, a neighborhood that has seen some of the heaviest Israeli shelling and airstrikes of the war. Among the dead Wednesday, three members of a Palestinian police bomb disposal unit. Their chief said they died, trying to spare others the same fate. An explosion went off, perhaps due to a mistake, he says, which in turn caused several subsequent explosions to take place. The blast shattered the unit's base, scattering all kinds of munitions gathered during 5 weeks of war. Also killed were Associated Press videographer Simone Camilli and his Palestinian translator Ali Shenda Abu Afsa, who had been following the bomb disposal team. 35-year-old Camilli is the first foreign journalist to die covering Operation Protective Edge and was a respected and familiar face to many who report on conflict in the region.
We are shocked. I can't believe it until now that this thing happened, that we really lost Simone, and Jerusalem lost Simone, and Palestine in general lost Simone. Simone, he was one of my brothers that I learned from him a lot. He was a great man. He was a great cameraman. He was real human.
Another AP photographer was badly wounded. According to Palestinian officials, 15 local journalists have also died covering the conflict. Unexploded ordnance is always a deadly leftover of war, threatening returning civilians and aid workers. No one can say for sure how much there is to be found and diffused here, but now there are even fewer people to do the job. It is a sad fact of life. In Gaza, even ceasefires are deadly. Martin Savidge, CNN, Gaza City.